Welcome back to another episode of our Jesus FAQ series. My name is Sammi, and today we're going to be unpacking a very commonly asked question about God and Christianity. Why is there evil and suffering in the world? Often we hear people ask why a good and just God would allow bad things to happen to people. This definitely isn't an easy topic to wrestle with either, especially with the year that we all experienced back in 2020. So let's start by looking at where evil started according to the Bible. In the beginning, God created a perfect world for us to live in, but because the first man and woman disobeyed God, we were separated from him by the bad things that we do. Our disobedience from what God tells us to do is called sin, and because God is perfect and the opposite of sin, suffering and evil cannot come from him. They come from humanity. Mark 7:21 through 23 summarizes sin and all of the crazy, bad things that come from within us. It says, "From within, out of the heart of man, come evil thoughts, sexual immorality, theft, murder, adultery, coveting, wickedness, deceit, sensuality, envy, slander, pride, foolishness. All these evil things come from within, and they defile a person." More simply put, evil and suffering exist because we live in a broken world that is corrupt by our human nature. Next, let's address a common misconception. Evil and suffering exist not because God is powerless to do anything about it, but because he is giving us the choice to follow him or not. If God kept all evil things from happening, which is totally within his power to do, we would literally be acting as slaves or puppets instead of his children. God created us to have a relationship with him, not to control our every move. God will never force you into obedience. He wants you to come to him and seek him from your own free will. In our own relationships with family and friends, we can't force someone to love us. It just doesn't work if the other person doesn't choose it. And because God gives us choices, there will always be evil that exists in the world when people choose not to do good things and not to follow him. Don't mistake this as an indifference toward our pain. God cares deeply about suffering and injustice. The most unjust thing to ever happen was when Jesus, who had lived a perfect and innocent life, died to save us from the mistakes we made. God put justice aside and willingly endured suffering in order to save you. In this way, Jesus experienced pain and suffering himself, everything from the death of loved ones to betrayal from his own friends to his ultimate execution on the cross. This means that God intimately knows what suffering is like. The first part of Psalm 105 says, "The Lord is good and his love endures forever." So when we think about all the bad things that happen in the world, it is extremely important to remember that God also gives us hope for a future where there will be no more suffering. Here is the picture that God paints for that future if we choose to trust in him. Revelation 21:4 through 5 says, "God will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain." God wants to bring healing. He wants us to be whole, and he wants us to trust in his plan as we navigate the inevitable suffering and pain of this life. Don't be mistaken. Following Jesus does not mean you won't ever experience suffering again, but it does mean that you'll never have to walk through it alone. Thank you for watching another episode of our Jesus FAQ series. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel by clicking the button below. We hope that you enjoyed this episode and look forward to seeing you again soon.